Yeah, guys, Ange Bishop, she's in Melbourne for the Australian Formula One Grand Prix and is trackside with the best seats in the house. Good morning, Ange. Today's the first day that the F1 drivers hit the track, but there's already been a lot happening at the Grand Prix.
Very true, Tristan, very true. I am in my happy place. This is the Channel 10 suite in the Paddock Club. You know me, you know I love the smell of petrol in the morning. And boy, am I smelling it right now, because this is pit lane. And right beyond pit lane is the start and finishing line of the Australian Formula One Grand Prix here in Melbourne. And that above it is blue sky and sunshine, in case you're unfamiliar with that. And that is what we are seeing in Melbourne at the moment. The weather is going to be perfect. Right below me will be star drivers like our own Daniel Ricciardo. It's the Williams racing team below me, so Daniel will be a bit further up. Lewis Hamilton, you name it, your favourite driver, will be down here in the pit lanes a bit later today when the first practice sessions take place. And we'll hear the cars on the track at about 1 p.m. But things are already underway. This is looking like being a record-breaking weekend here at the Formula One, and it all kicked off yesterday with the Mercedes Ladies Day lunch. And that was a chance to, believe it or not, catch a glimpse of one of the most popular drivers on the track. Yes, I'm talking Lewis Hamilton. Take a look.
And it's so exciting to be back here at the Mercedes-Benz Star Lounge. It was where we were the day before the world ended. So it feels really great to be back, and I'm just excited to have everybody back together and all dressed up and ready to go for a great week. Okay, so I'm wearing a dress from Forward, a vintage Bottega, and my own brand Lana Wilkinson shoes.
Oh, Ange, we are just so thrilled to be here. Look, there's real humans in the room. We can connect, we can talk, and I think this year it's all about just counting our blessings, realising how lucky we are to be here, and celebrate Formula One.
And have a wonderful time. We'll chat to you really soon and give you a heads up before the special guest comes. Have fun, everyone.
I can tell you and you what's happening, because they don't know at this stage that I'm going to be interviewing Lewis Hamilton, 7-time world champion, most phenomenal global athlete. I personally adore him. He's such an incredible human, stands for such wonderful social issues, so important to him. So they've got no idea, so they're going to be beside themselves. So I'm going to love it when you have a room full of women realise that Lewis Hamilton's going to be here in about 10 minutes.
Lewis Hamilton!
I think at the moment, diversity has got to be one of the main focuses for us, but gender equality particularly as well. It's something that, I've been in this sport for 29 years. I started when I was 8 and 16 years in professional, but majority male-dominated industry has always been a white-dominated industry, white male-dominated industry.
It'd be fair to say that the ladies were a lot more interested in Lewis Hamilton than the cars. And why wouldn't they be? Especially when he talked about the role of women in Formula One.
There's no female drivers coming through currently that I've noticed. We've got to change that. But there's so many jobs in the background, and it's just about encouraging women to want to get involved and creating an environment where they feel comfortable, included, and treated equally. When I would ask questions to our leaders, they would never have an answer. They wouldn't have the right answers. They would be like, I don't know. I'd be like, why there's not many women within the company? Why there's not any women in our sport? Why don't we have female drivers? And there was never an adequate answer.
How many of the ladies here do you think were interested in cars, and how many are interested in Lewis?
Okay, so I think before Lewis spoke, about 10% were interested in cars. Since Lewis spoke, I think 95% either want to be his wife or somehow get trackside for the rest of this event.
He was incredible, wasn't
also,
he?
Also, I'm single, Lewis, so yeah. Hi.
Well, I landed here on Monday night. I've always wanted to have piano lessons, so like Tuesday and Wednesday I've been having these piano lessons.
It feels here? Similar.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, you fit piano lessons in. What does that do for your brain when you're preparing for a race?
Well, it just challenges your mind, naturally being able to focus on something different. When I leave the racetrack and when I'm not at the racetrack, I'm not thinking about racing a lot.
Wow.
I try and switch off. I skydive. I like surfing. So I was at the surf pool last night, last two nights at 10 p.m. till 12, surfing. in the surf pool because there's sharks here.
But he spoke about his mum and diversity and inclusion, and when he revealed that he's been playing piano since he landed in Melbourne on Monday night. What a guy.
I love it. He did skydiving in Dubai, piano playing in Melbourne. It's all good.
And now he's doing surf lessons as well, 10 p.m. until midnight at a fake, you know, surf beach that we have in Melbourne, which is really popular, because he's too scared to go in the water, but he's taking up surf lessons. Who needs to do hot laps and practice for one of the world's biggest races when he can play piano and surf?
The other thing Lewis has found time to do is sign my hat. That's his number, 44. So I'm pretty happy with that. And what he was saying about women in F1, it is fascinating. Actually, only 5 women have ever driven in a Formula One race. One woman won one race back in 1980. But there are things starting to happen. Mercedes had Susie Wolf, who raced in a practice lap or drove in a practice lap at the British Grand Prix. And Williams below me has a development driver, Jamie Chadwick, who's a female, obviously. And in fact, there's your first Saudi Arabian woman, Rima Jafali, to hold a racing license. She got it the same month Saudi Arabia finally allowed women to drive cars. So it is happening, and it will eventually, because in other formula racing, women do compete against the men. So it will happen eventually. But in the meantime, so excited to bring you more from the Grand Prix throughout the show. I'm going to have some very special guests here in the 10 suite. We're going to talk all things GP. I'll be back with you soon.
Great stuff. And enjoy your surfing lessons tonight, Ange. Have a good time.